Friends, good morning, it's Arun here. So this is the first day of the new year 2020. It's time for everyone to set goals in life, to set multiple goals as per various deadlines, to set goals in various fields of life, for example, health, career, happiness, relationships, love, affection, and so on and so forth. There is a more popular terminology for this process of goal setting in the month of December or January every year. We call it as New Year resolutions. So friends, which are the top 10 New Year resolutions which are most commonly used by people? Let me bring the list of the top 10 resolutions for my audience. The first most popular New Year resolution is to exercise more often. The second, to lose weight. The third, to get organized. The fourth, learn a new skill or hobby. Fifth, live life to the fullest. Sixth, save more money or spend less. Seventh, quit smoking. Eighth, spend more time with family. Ninth, travel more and visit new places. And 10th, read more books. Now there is another website, friends, which makes a list of top 3 resolutions. Top 3. And these are doing exercise, losing weight, and saving money. Now these are just examples. There could be more. Someone would want a better job with a higher salary. Someone would decide to get his or her admission assured in an Ivy League institution or university. Someone would decide to dump negativity around him or her and get another job with a better manager. Are you also making a new resolution, friends? I'm pretty sure many of you might have thought of, if not really made, a new resolution. It's all great, there's nothing wrong with it. You should make a new resolution or goals. But दोस्तों हमेशा याद रखिएगा, आपको वो नहीं मिलता है जो आप चाहते हैं, आपको वो मिलता है जो आप चाहते ही चाहते ही चाहते ही चाहते ही चाहते हैं. Now, are you ready to bear the pain while doing weightlifting, for example, after being home late in the evening from a grueling and busy day? Are you ready to say no to those luscious cheese-dropping pizzas or a sparkling golden yellow French fries with a tiny hint of salt? Can you keep your resolve of eating healthy while still smelling the fragrance of that freshly fried potato veggies? Can you turn your face away from that sparkling, tangy, fizzy drink which your favorite movie star has been asking you to drink as it makes him more adventurous? Can you have the tenacity to write a few pages of your dream book late in the night while you are also expected to have a busy day ahead in the office tomorrow? Can you say no to your close buddies who want you to join over that Friday evening booze and dance party, which is going to go until late in the morning hours next day? Can you say no because you have to apply for your dream Ivy League university or finish that last chapter of your long pending dream book? Now friends, can you decide to quit smoking, for example, because you know it does not help you anyway? With each puff, you are inhaling 400 to thousands of toxic chemicals into your precious lungs. Can you say no to your friends who want you to join them outside the main gate of office building because it's such a fun talking rubbish against a bad manager while looking at the circles of smoke vanishing up in the thin air? And gossip as an accompaniment to smoking is such a great fun. It's such a great fun, friends. It's really difficult, isn't it? Now you are getting why sustaining New Year resolutions is such a pain. Why only less than 10% of people actually keep their New Year resolutions on? If you want to experience this, go to a jogger's park the next morning, friends. Go there tomorrow morning and go there for next few days or weeks. The place will be swarming with youngsters and elderly in the first few days of the New Year. But go there after a month and the place and most of the crowd would have vanished. Yes. only 8 out of 100 people who were present in the first week in that Joggers Park would have been visible after a month or so. So friends, why does it happen and how to be counted in only 8% of people to be precise who keep their New Year resolutions? It's a mouth-watering question and makes me smile, friends. We are living in a society which is programming us to fail in our resolutions every single day. That's the reason why 92% of people fail in keeping their New Year resolutions. But remaining 8% people will succeed. I will discuss about this in the coming videos, but let me give you a clue. This is the law of this universe. This is the law of the success, and this is as true as the law of gravity. But friends, a good news. You are very close to that 8% of group if you are watching this video till the end, even till now, for your self-development and excellence. And you will be in 8%, final 8%, if you take actions, which we will be discussing in next videos. But friends, for the time being, congratulations for being in minority, that is in a very small percentage in the society. Because the very fact that you are still on with this video, it proves beyond doubt that you want to make a difference in your life in this new year 2020. Have a great new year 2020 and have a wonderful, amazing, beautiful, awesome day ahead, friends. Take care and see you again.